Penguin Random House presents How Business Storytelling Works, Increase Your Influence and Impact, read by Sandeep Das.
Hi, my name is Sandeep Das. I am the author of this book, How Business Storytelling Works, and you will listen to the rest of the book in my voice. Before we start, let me ask you this one question, or maybe you are thinking about this question. Why exactly should you listen to this book? So you've either bought this book or are considering buying this book by listening to this preface. Bear with me and listen to the next few pages before you decide to drop this book and watch the latest Instagram reel instead. Before I make my elevator pitch for listening to this book, let me ask you a very simple question. Who do you think is the greatest storyteller of all time? Take a minute before you answer. Do not come up with multiple answers. Narrow down and just come up with one. Just one name. I've done this exercise at many storytelling workshops. Their answers, and hopefully yours, will revolve around the following names: Barack Obama, Steve Jobs, Narendra Modi, Aaron Sorkin, Sheryl Sandberg, Elon Musk, Christopher Nolan, my personal favorite, Indra Nooyi, or Johnny Depp. What is the number one skill you need? It is quite obvious to say that there is a lot of noise around us with so many ads, so many social media feeds, toxic bosses, nosy relatives, irritating friends who seem to be leading the perfect life, so many pundits jumping up and down trying to motivate you by selling something to you, and so on. I've also captured this illustrative in figure P.1 in case you want to refer to it. It is also obvious that the world, especially after the COVID pandemic, is changing faster than ever before. There was talk of 100% remote work, which was followed by a hybrid working model that'll evolve into something else by the time this book has reached your hand or reached your phone. We are ridiculously divided as a population, ready to unleash a torrential wave of hatred and pounce on each other. There are millions of us, including me, trying to be influencers. I'm sure even you are. There are millions of us trying to be entrepreneurs. In this very complicated world, the single biggest facet that is lacking is trust and authenticity. Everyone is trying to sell amidst so much noise. One of India's leading advertising moguls, Prasoon Joshi, a brilliant man, recently mentioned that the biggest quality that is required between a creator and an audience is trust. Do not think a creator only means a social media influencer. A creator stands for everyone. An entrepreneur, a corporate professional, a marketing head, a student, or even an author like me. Storytelling as a tool helps you bridge that critical gap by sounding authentic and building that missing level of trust. As someone who does marketing and understands human psychology during the hours of the day, the single biggest human insight over this upcoming decade is the need for authenticity and the need for trust. You might be thinking if storytelling is really that important, or if it is just another fancy tool to have by your side. Consider the two following examples. One of the biggest reasons why Hillary Clinton lost the 2016 United States presidential election is because she was perceived to be stiff and not authentic. The second example, I wrote an opinion piece for a leading newspaper on why tennis superstar Novak Djokovic is not loved as much as Roger Federer, my favorite, or Rafa Nadal. In one line, I summarize the entire story as follows. Novak is trying to be Batman when he is actually Joker. His lack of perceived authenticity is primarily why he is not a fan favorite. You may ask, is storytelling only for CEOs? No, it isn't. It's meant for everyone. For corporate professionals, for entrepreneurs, for sports stars, for brands and marketeers, for actors, for sales professionals, For Gen Z professionals looking for their first job, for the chief experience officer or a CXO trying to pitch for the CEO's job, for aspiring politicians trying to get the president's or the prime minister's job, even for a terrorist trying to create global havoc. For authors like me, for professors teaching in business schools, and finally, the most importantly, for you. In fact, storytelling helps you deal with friends and those very nasty relatives. Although I'm not sure whether storytelling can land you your dream date, I wouldn't rule it out either. If you take a view over thousands of years, and we discuss this in a subsequent chapter, the reason you and I have survived the hazardous journey of human evolution is our ability to tell stories. We've survived over every other species because we could create these artificial, mythical stories like the notion of countries, religion, and corporates. Please don't conclude that I don't believe in God. I do, especially when my increments at work are not up to the mark. So, what is a story? As a good or a rather bad storyteller, I'm introducing the concept of a story after I have told you why it is so important. A story is what your grandmother narrated to you when you were younger. It often had the construct, like once upon a time, there was this monster trying to create a problem. Then there was this great hero who fought against all odds and beat the monster. For the nerds out there, and I'm sure there are quite a few, a story can be summarized in the following format. A conflict, followed by a struggle, followed by a resolution. We will consider this in detail in a subsequent chapter to understand how your favorite movies and your favorite web series are written in the above format. Who is Sandeep Das? That is, who am I? In case you haven't figured it out, I'm referring to myself, the author of this book, and the person's voice you're listening to right now. The reason you should listen to this book is not because I'm a great storyteller, but because I have done this every day at my place of work for the last 15 years. I've been trained in business storytelling and I've studied human insight and behavioral psychology for a long, long time. During my leadership role in management consulting, I used to interact with CEOs every day and have picked up nuances of good and even bad storytelling from them. This book is replete with those interesting anecdotes. I've spoken about business storytelling on over 100 platforms with leading CXOs across the Tata Group, Godrej, TCS or Tata Consultancy Services, Deloitte, Accenture Strategy, PwC and so on. And to the best management students across the National University of Singapore, the famed Indian Institutes of Technology and the Indian Institutes of Management, IITs and IIMs. And I've written over 100 opinion pieces in leading publications such as The Economic Times, The Times of India, Fortune and Forbes on some of these nuances. Also, if you've read my previous book, Hacks for Life and Career, A Millennial's Guide to Making It Big, you are probably a fan already. I do like showing off my humility. How do you get the most out of this book? This book is not about academic frameworks, but real-world applications of storytelling techniques, irrespective of whether you are an entrepreneur, a brand manager, a Gen Z professional, a corporate sales professional, a CEO, a movie star, or a TikTok influencer. It gives you a real-life primer that your peers are currently using now. Trust me, they are. As shown in figure P.2, this book is divided into three primary sections. The first section sets up the foundation. The second section delves into the application of storytelling for corporates. And the third section aids in your personal growth. This book is divided into 14 easy-to-read chapters, excluding this preface you're listening to, with loads of contemporary and popular culture examples. If I were you, I would listen to 2 to 3 chapters every weekend and wrap the book up in 30 to 45 days. And then post on social media what you loved about this book. Needless to say, given the highly entertaining writer I am quite sure you will go faster than that. So sit back and enjoy. Without any doubt, this is my bravest book. Exploring an exotic concept like storytelling by deriving storytelling principles from evolution, psychology, and the world of movies, and then using these principles to find numerous applications in our professional lives is seriously daunting. In hindsight, I think that God has blessed me with immense luck and immense self-belief that I could even think of pulling this off. I'm grateful to you, Almighty, first of all. I have a lot of people to thank for helping me finish my fourth book and encouraging me immensely along the way. Without a doubt, my mom and dad, for having supported me in whatever I have wanted to do. A special thanks to my editors, Manish Kumar and Manisha Matthews. They are excellent editors. Their timely inputs, infinite patience to tolerate my stupidity, and sheer knowledge have pushed the book up by many, many notches. Finally, thanks to everyone who read a few chapters along the way and gave me their valuable and sometimes not so valuable feedback. So let's start with part one, where we understand the foundations of storytelling. And essentially, we'll delve into five key questions. Question one, what is the number one reason you are alive today? Slightly tricky, I know, but that's question one. Question two, what is the number one reason you will be alive tomorrow? A trickier question, I guess. Question three, how does storytelling impact your brain? Question four, how does Hollywood use storytelling? And question five, how will storytelling play out in our world over the next few years? So let's start chapter one, which is, why is storytelling the number one reason you're here today? And let me get you started with two very interesting quotes. Quote number one, the most powerful person in the world is the storyteller. The storyteller sets the vision, the values, and agenda of an entire generation to come. Do you know who said this? The person who made your iPhone. Quote number two, don't believe everything you hear. There are always three sides to a story. Yours, theirs, and the truth. This is an anonymous one I've taken from the internet. So let's start. How long have you been alive on this planet? I understand this may not be the best line to start a book. So let me reframe the question. How long do you think our species, humans, or Homo sapiens, has been alive on this planet? For the aspiring nerds, Homo sapiens means wise man in Latin. What is your best guess? 5,000 years? 50,000 years? The actual answer is in excess of 200,000 years. At least that far long, and maybe much, much more. To put this number into perspective, the world didn't have Instagram, TikTok, or the iPhone then. Not even the computer, and many, many more things. Given their miserable lives without social media, have you wondered how they survived for so many tens of thousands of years? After all, humans are not the fastest runners. They can't outrun a cheetah. They don't have claws to pounce on their prey. Your pointy nails come close, but not close enough. They can't hunt like a lion. They don't swim fast enough. They can't outswim a shark. They don't camouflage very well in the wild. They can't camouflage like a chameleon. When I ask this question on why humans survive for so long at storytelling workshops that I conduct, I get a variety of answers ranging from their intelligence and ability to communicate through language to curiosity to learn about nature. While some of this may be true, the number one reason that you're alive today and listening to this book is, as the chapter name suggests, the power of storytelling. The question is, how? Create an invincible...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.